Hey guys, Ivan here, and for this video, we're gonna go back in time. About 22 years ago, it is 1999, Mr. Olympia. It is arguably, in my opinion, the most competitive, the deepest, the toughest lineup ever in any bodybuilding show in bodybuilding history. And what is the most impressive thing about this show is the pure domination of Ronnie Coleman. The lineup was so incredibly deep. All these guys here standing are legends. They are all super, super genetically blessed bodybuilders, and they all brought amazing shape to this stage. Sonny Schmidt, Jay Cutler, Nasser El Sambari, Mike Materazzo, Chris Cormier, Jean-Pierre Fuchs, Ronnie Coleman. You can also see Dexter Jackson. Then there is also Flex Wheeler. There is Marcus Rule, Kevin Levroni, Sean Ray, Lee Priest, Miloš Šarčev right there on the right, Paul Dillette, Ernie Taylor as well. It is just ridiculous. What a lineup this was. As you can see, the top 10, pure legends. But even the guys out of top 10, the guys in top 16, also legends of the sport. Mike Materazzo, Ernie Taylor, Pavle Blonitsky, Jay Cutler, Jean-Pierre Fuchs and Marcus Rule. Guys, is there anybody in this lineup that isn't a legend of the sport? There isn't, just all legends in one lineup. And what is the most impressive thing here is that Ronnie Coleman pretty much destroyed them, annihilated them all. He killed them. I might be mistaken, it's not exactly right to compare eras, but I feel like most guys here in their best shape could be the winner of 2021 Mr. Olympia. Could Marcus Rule at his best beat Big Ramy? Maybe. Jean-Pierre Fuchs? Also maybe. Jay Cutler? Easily, I would say. Pavle Blonitsky? Maybe. Ernie Taylor? I don't know about that. I don't know about Mike Materazzo and Miloš Šarčev. Dexter Jackson at his best? I can see that. Lee Priest? Probably not. Paul Dillette? Maybe. Nasser El Sambari, Sean Ray, Kevin Levroni, Chris Cormier, Flex Wheeler and Ronnie Coleman? I feel like all these guys could annihilate Big Ramy, and I'm not like a proponent of 90s era, I think I'm being objective. Like, you have to choose one, Mr. Olympia, to say this was the most competitive one, and I don't feel like it's 2021, 2020, 2019, 2018 was decent, but I don't know, I feel like 1999 is the one. Just look at the frame, the size, the conditioning of freaking Ronnie Coleman. This is probably his best ever. Like 2003, he was bigger. 1998, he was more shredded and streamlined. But I think 1999, he was bigger and he was still streamlined and had a small waist. The gut was in check and he was really conditioned. So I think this was the best Ronnie Coleman ever. Nasser was, I think, far better in 1997. Paul Dillette, it was a decent Paul Dillette, but, you know, with his posing, he could have been much better if he improved that, but he was still huge, he was shredded. It was an amazing lineup. In the background, you can see Sean Ray, Marcus Rule. This is just ridiculous. All these guys on stage at once. Kevin Levroni on the left, very, very big, not streamlined as he was once, but very big. Sean Ray, Lee Priest and Dexter Jackson, the smaller guys in one lineup. For me personally, Dexter looks the best here, but this was his first Mr. Olympia ever. Marcus Rule, he was better later, actually, in the early 2000s. Miloš Šarčev did crack the top 10 here, but I think he was better looking in 1997, though he got bigger here. He improved the size of his arms with oil and stuff. He talked about that openly. Size is what they were looking for here. He brought more size and he placed better, but I prefer his 1997 look. Now we go to the top 3. And this is Chris Cormier at his best, third place in the Mr. Olympia. Ronnie Coleman just looking like a freaking alien. And then Flex Wheeler, who was much bigger here, not as streamlined as he was in 1993, for example, but still had decent lines. And he brought good level of muscularity and conditioning. It just still wasn't freaky enough to beat the best of all time, Ronnie Coleman. But look at his arms. Look at the size of this guy. Look at the joints. I mean, look at the size of his joint, his wrist compared to his arm. The shoulders were a little bit smaller. I think, I feel like, it looks like he made his arms that big with oil, because they don't really look proportionate compared to his shoulders. Probably even chest, but he looked freaky, he looked crazy here. But then you compare him to Ronnie Coleman right there, and he just looks much less impressive, right? Then from behind, again, same thing happens. I mean, look at the Flex Wheeler alone. He looks amazing in this pose, in every pose, basically. But look at the glutes. Look at the conditioning in the glutes. Who had more, like, who had drier glutes? More separation, deeper cuts, just harder glutes than Ronnie? Nobody, ever. Up to this day, I think. And the back. Look at Ronnie's back. Nobody ever had a back like this, and it's hard to imagine somebody else in the future bringing better back than this, because this is pretty much as good as back can get. This is probably like the ultimate back, the most complete, like the back. You know, it can't get much better than this. So he absolutely killed everybody, even though all these guys are absolutely phenomenal. Watching this video, I feel like Chris Cormier probably deserved to be second. I wasn't there, so I can't make a proper assessment, but I think he was more conditioned, especially through the glutes. He didn't have some freaky body parts like Flex Wheeler, but he had less flaws, I feel like. But anyways, I don't think it was a mistake giving it to Flex, so it was very close, I think. But Ronnie Coleman, even though these guys were absolutely outstanding, he still stood a few steps ahead of them. Even though these two guys are absolutely incredible, Ronnie Coleman made them seem average because of his pretty much perfect physique. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this higher quality footage that I stumbled upon and my commentary as well. If you did enjoy it, please give it a like. And if you want to see more videos like this, subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. All the best and bye-bye.